Hopkins here with Container Collective Yoga in Lakewood, Colorado for a, let's say, gentle power flow practice. I'm 7.5 months pregnant right now, so I'm definitely adapting my practice, but I feel like it's actually being really great for people who are needing some modifications in doing a power flow practice, but not sure quite where to go with it. So just follow along and see what happens. All right, we'll get started in child's pose. So you can have your big toes touching if you like, or they can be apart. You can bring your knees nice and wide on your mat, if not wider than your mat, and walk your fingertips forward towards the front of your mat. If your forehead rests on the ground, great. If it doesn't, I'm gonna use a block right now in my practice. And rest your forehead on a block. And we'll take 5 breaths together here. Breathe in. Full breath out. Breath in. Pull your belly button to your spine. Breathe out. 3 more breaths in. And out. Breath in. Press your hips 1 inch closer to your heels. Breathe out. One more time. Breathe in. Breathe out. Come up onto your hands and knees. Bring your knees hip distance apart, your hands a little wider than your shoulders. We'll take a few cows and cats. Inhale, arch your spine, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, round your spine, press the back of your rib cage up to the ceiling. Again, inhale, cow pose. Press your hands down, pull them back towards your knees. Exhale, round, push your hands down and forward to stretch out your mat. Do that one more time. Inhale, cow pose. And exhale, cat. Walk your hands forward on your mat about 6 to 10 inches. Curl your toes under and send your hips up to the ceiling. You can have really bent knees here to start out. And the goal is to push your shoulders from being over your wrist back to creating one line of energy from your wrist through your shoulders up to your hips. Take 3 more breaths here. And out. Pull your belly button to your spine. Breathe in. And out. One more breath in. And out. Walk your hands back to your feet. Ragdoll. You can have your feet hip distance apart, maybe wider. If that's too much strain on your low back or too much pressure on your belly, you can put your forearms on your knees and connect your fingertips together. Otherwise, you're invited to interlace your hands in opposite elbow creases. Let your head hang heavy for 2 more breaths here. One more breath. Release your hands. You have the option to bring your big toes to touch or leave them wide apart. Roll all the way up to standing mountain pose. Reach your fingertips up to the ceiling. Breathe in. Pull your hands into heart center. Exhale. Let's do that 2 more times. Inhale, mountain pose. Extend your hands to the sky. Exhale. Pull your hands into heart center. Exhale. One more time. Inhale, reach up to the ceiling. Hands to heart center. Exhale. We'll do some adapted sun salutations. A, inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Flat back, lengthen your spine. Pull your shoulder blades together on your back. Exhale, walk your hands to the front of your mat, high plank. Or tabletop. You could do a low plank to upward facing dog or a cow pose, inhale. And a cat pose, exhale. Curl your toes under, walk your hands forward a few inches, downward facing dog. So that's the adaptation I'm going to do for sun salutations. Moving forward is the cow and the cat, as opposed to the chaturanga, which is the low plank into the upward facing dog. Just not accessible for my body right now, and that is perfectly okay. Take 1 more breath here. Exhale, walk your hands back to your feet. Flat back, breathe in. Exhale, fold. Mountain pose, inhale, reach up to the ceiling, inhale. Hands to heart center, exhale. Mountain pose, breathe in. Forward fold, breathe out. Flat back, breathe in. Pull your shoulder blades together on your spine. Exhale, walk your hands forward, either high plank with the push-up or a cow pose on an inhale. Exhale, cat. Downward facing dog, curl your toes under. Walk your hands towards the front of your mat, send your hips up to the ceiling. One more breath here in. Full breath out. Walk your hands back to your feet. Try to alternate which hand you start the walk back with. Flat back, breathe in. Exhale, fold. Mountain pose, inhale. Hands to heart center, exhale. Moving into an adapted sun salutation, B, chair pose. Sit your hips low to the floor. Reach your arms overhead. Shift your weight back into your heels so you can see your toes in front of your knees. Pull your belly up to your spine. Press your feet down into your mat and squeeze your inner thighs towards midline. Not to a point where your knees knock in towards each other. Your knees continue to track over your feet, over your toes, with an inward action, pulling towards center line. Take a deep breath in. Lift your upper arm bones towards the back of the room. Exhale, forward fold. Flat back, breathe in. Walk your hands forward, high plank or tabletop. Inhale, arch your spine. Exhale, round your spine. Downward facing dog, send your hips up to the ceiling. Right foot warrior one. You might lower down to your knees. Grab a block under your left hand to step your right foot to the front of your mat. Turn your back foot flat to the mat. Pull your belly button to your spine and reach your arms overhead. Warrior one, Virabhadrasana one. Ujjayi breath in, Ujjayi breath out. Push down through the pinky toe edge of your back foot to create strength and length in your back leg. Take two more breaths here in and out. Lunge 1 inch deeper into your front knee. Look up, stretch up, maybe even back. On your next exhale, bring your left hand back down to the block. Step your right knee back to meet your left. Take a cow and a cat, inhale and exhale. Downward facing dog, send your hips up to the ceiling. Left foot warrior one. Step your left foot to the front of your mat. You may grab a block under your right hand. Bring your left foot forward to the front of your mat. Turn your back foot flat to the back and extend your arms overhead. Ujjayi breath in. Ujjayi breath out. Pull your belly button in and up to support your low back. Push down through the pinky toe edge of your back foot to fire up your right leg muscles. Take two more breaths here in. Lunge 1 inch deeper into your front knee, breathe out. Look up, stretch up and back, breathe in. Exhale, come back down. Right hand to the block. Lower your back knee to the mat, step back to tabletop. Take a cow pose, breathe in. And a cat pose, breathe out. Walk your hands forward a few inches, downward facing dog. Deep breath in, deep breath out. We'll do that slow sun B variation one more time through. Walk your hands back to your feet. Flat back, breathe in. Fold, exhale. Chair pose, sit your hips low to the floor. Squeeze your legs and feet towards midline. Extend your arms overhead, up towards the ceiling. Ujjayi breath in. Sit 2 inches lower into your chair, breathe out. Inhale, reach your upper arm bones to the back of the room. Exhale, forward fold. Flat back, inhale. Walk your hands forward, high plank to low plank, or take a cow and a cat. Inhale, arch your spine. Exhale, round. Downward facing dog. Send your hips up to the ceiling. One breath in, one breath out. Right foot warrior one. Step your right foot between your hands. Turn your back foot flat to the mat. Extend your arms overhead. Take two breaths in. Lunge deep into your front knee and breathe out. If your front knee goes beyond the level of your heel, slide your right foot a few inches further forward. One more breath. Exhale, make your way to tabletop for a cow and cat. Inhale, arch your spine. Exhale, round your spine. Downward facing dog. One breath in. One breath out. Left foot warrior one. You may use the block to get there. Step your left foot between your to the front of your mat. Turn your back foot flat to the mat. And extend your arms overhead. Ujjayi breath in, loud breath in. Lunge deeper into your front and breathe out. One more breath in. Full breath out. Bring your hands down to your mat. Cow and cat. Inhale, arch your spine. Exhale, round your spine. Walk your hands forward, downward facing dog. Three breaths here in and out. Breath in. Pull your belly button to your spine. Breathe out. Press your chest closer to your thighs. And walk your hands back to your feet. Flat back. Breathe in. Fold. Exhale. Mountain pose. Inhale. Pull your hands into heart center. Exhale. Eagle pose. You may use a block on either side of your front of your feet. You can have it whatever height works for you. So you start in chair pose. Bring your left leg up and over your right leg. You can push your left foot down into the block. Lift the front of your pelvis up to neutral. Option to keep your hands on your hips or bring your left leg arm under the right arm and give yourself a bear hug. If you feel a great stretch, stay here and breathe or wind your forearms up like ropes as well. Ujjayi breath in. You could choose to test your balance if you want to try and lift your left toes up off the block. One more Ujjayi breath in. Sit one inch lower, breathe out. Mountain pose, breathe in. Hands to heart center, exhale. Chair pose, sit your hips low to the floor, reach your arms overhead, breathe in. Bring your right leg up and over the left leg. Option to push your right toes into the block. Bring your right arm under your left arm. Give yourself a bear hug. Or wind your forearms up like ropes. Three breaths in. Sit 2 inches lower. Breathe out. Option to test your balance. Try to lift your right toes up off the block. Breathe out. One more breath in. And out. Release mountain pose, inhale. One more time each side. Bring your left leg up and over your right leg. Bring your left arm under your right arm. Ujjayi breath in, loud and clear. And exhale. Pull your shoulders towards the back of the room. One more breath in. Sit 1 inch lower, exhale. Mountain pose, inhale. Eagle on the other side. Bring your right leg up and over your left leg. Bend deep into your left knee. Bring your right arm under the left arm. Big breath in. Big breath out. Big breath in. Big breath out. One more breath. Sit 1 inch lower. Mountain pose. Inhale. Hands to heart center. Exhale. Tree pose. Stand onto your left foot. Bring your right foot up so that it's like a kickstand on your left ankle. You may choose to stay here and breathe. You may choose to bring your foot up into your inner calf. Wiggles and wobbles are a fact of life, and you breathe through them. If you have even more mobility through your hip, you may choose to bring your right foot up and into your left inner thigh. Take two more breaths here. One more. Pull your belly button in and up towards your spine. Switch sides. Stand on your right leg, bring your left foot up, either to a kickstand or to your inner calf or inner thigh. Set your gaze, your drishti, at one spot out in front of you and breathe. Put pressure between your foot and your leg and equal pressure back from your leg into your foot. Take one more breath here. Release. Dancer pose. Stand on your left foot. Reach back to grab onto your right ankle. If this is too much and you need support, you can step to a wall, put your hand onto a wall. You may stay right here because you feel plenty of stretch in your right quadricep. Or you can slide your right hand over your toes to the inner arch of your right foot. Extend your left hand up to the ceiling, breathe in. Option to kick your foot towards the wall behind you. Then reach your left hand towards the top of the wall in front of you. Take two more breaths here, in and out. One more breath in. Kick 1 inch further back, breathe out. Switch sides. Stand on your right foot. Shake out your left leg, because that was a lot. Grab onto your left inner arch of your foot. Option to use a wall for balance and support. Extend your right hand up to the ceiling. Ujjayi breath in. Pull your belly in and up towards your spine. Kick your left leg to the back of the room. Take two more breaths. One more breath. Kick 1 inch further. Release. Mountain pose, breathe in. Forward fold, breathe out. Flat back, breathe in. Make your way into downward facing dog. However you can get there, walk your feet to the back of your mat. You could take another cow and cat pose or another chaturanga, up dog, down dog. Big breath in, big breath out. Triangle pose. You may come down onto your knees to get to triangle pose. Step your right foot to the front of your mat. Turn your back foot flat to the mat. Grab a block the tall height outside of your right foot. Extend your left hand up to the ceiling. Straighten your right leg. Ujjayi breath. You may need two blocks stacked on top of each other for triangle pose. Pull your belly button to your spine and squeeze your legs towards each other, towards the center of your mat. And if it's comfortable for your neck, look up to the ceiling. Giant breath in. Giant breath out. One more breath in. Full breath out. Release your left hand down to your block. Step your right knee back to meet your left knee. One cow and one cat. Inhale. Exhale, round. Downward facing dog. Walk your hands forward a few inches. Send your hips up to the ceiling. One breath in. Breath out. Lower your knees to your mat. Triangle on the left side. Set your left foot to the front of your mat. Turn your back foot flat to the mat to straighten your back leg. Grab a block outside of your left knee, maybe two blocks. Straighten your right hand up to the ceiling and straighten your left leg. Option to look up to your top thumb. Take two more breaths here. One more breath in. Full breath out. Release your hands down to your mat. Tabletop for a cow and a cat. Inhale, arch your spine. Exhale, round. Downward facing dog. Walk your hands forward on your mat, send your hips up to the ceiling. Deep breath in, deep breath out. One more breath in, one more breath out. Come down onto your knees. We'll make our way into camel pose. So you may need to fold up the front edge of your mat for a little more cushion under your knees. Curl your toes under. Lift the front of your pelvis up. Lift your shoulders up to your ears. Roll your shoulders onto your back as you look up the ceiling. Press your hands into your low back to create length through your low back towards the floor. Take two more breaths here and out. One more breath in and out. Slowly come up. With your toes curled under, sit back onto your heels. Rest your palms down on your thighs or palms up on your thighs. This is also known as screaming toes pose because of the stretch that you create in the arch of your foot. Take one more breath here and out. We'll come up for one more camel pose. Pull your belly button to support your spine. Press your hands into your low back. Lift your sternum up to the ceiling. Two more breaths in and out. Squeeze your legs towards midline. Breathe in. Look up one inch further back. Breathe out. Come up slowly. Unroll your mat. Downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Come down onto your knees. Bring your feet around to the front of your mat. Set it for bridge pose. Grab a block so it's nearby. Lay down onto your back. And bring a block between your knees. Press your feet flat into the floor. Curl your tailbone under and lift your hips up to the ceiling. You could press your palms down into the floor if it's accessible. Clasp your hands behind your low back and shimmy your shoulders in a little closer together on your back. Squeeze into the block. Press your feet down into the mat. Lift your hips up towards the ceiling. And breathe on purpose. Two more breaths here. One more breath. Option to stay here or come down onto your back for one breath in. One breath out. And lift your hips back up to the ceiling. Bridge number two, or second and final bridge. Either push your palms flat into the floor or clasp behind your back. Or if wheel pose is in your practice, you want to bring your hands by your shoulders and lift your shoulders and head off the floor too. Go for that. Take two more breaths here. Squeeze the block, press your feet down, lift your hips up to the ceiling. And come down. Take the block away. Windshield wiper your knees from one side to the other. Roll over to one side and push into your top hip to come up for boat pose. Boat pose, grab the block again, put it back between your knees. I do it the wide way at this point. You could hold on to the back of your knees as you squeeze your legs in towards midline. Lift your shoulders up, roll them onto your back. Option to flex your toes. Deep breath in. So notice spine is on a diagonal. Breathe out. You could stay right here. You could float your feet off the floor. You could reach one or both arms out to the side. Ujjayi breath in. Ujjayi breath out. Two more breaths in and out. One more in and out. Breathe. release the block. And we'll come into figure four, seated figure four. Lean back onto your hands, bring your right ankle across your left thigh, then lift your left foot in close towards your sit bones. So the temptation is to collapse into your spine here. Push into your hands towards the back of your mat to expand your chest towards the front of the room. Flex your right toes, breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Three more breaths in and out. Two more breaths, re-engage your chest pressure towards the front of the room. One more last breath in and out. Extend your left leg long on your mat. Bring your right foot up into your left inner thigh. Create length in your spine. Extend your arms overhead. Breathe in. Exhale, hinge forward. Your hands may come to your shins. Your hands may come to your toes. Wherever you are, continue to open your chest towards the front of the room. Ujjayi breath in. Ujjayi breath out. Ujjayi breath in. Ujjayi breath out. One more breath. Allow yourself to go 1 inch further. Switch sides for figure four. Bring your left ankle across your right thigh. Lean back onto your hands to slide your right heel up towards your hips, or you could press into your hands to scoot your hips towards your foot. We'll take a few breaths here. Inhale. Press your chest towards the front of your mat, towards your shin. Take three more breaths here. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath in. And breath out. Extend your right leg long on your mat. Press your left foot into your right inner thigh. Inhale, lengthen through your spine. Exhale, tip your pelvis forward. Create a stretch on the back of your right leg. And breathe on purpose. Inhale. Exhale. Three more breaths in and out. Pull your shoulder blades together on your back to press your chest through your shoulders to the front of your mat. One more breath. Go at least 1 inch further. Come up. It's time to go upside down. You could choose waterfall pose or headstand or handstand or shoulder stand, waterfall pose. You lay onto your back, put your hips onto a block, extend your feet up to the ceiling. Flex your feet down towards your face and breathe on purpose. You could close your eyes and let your drishti, your gaze, settle on the back of your forehead, or with your eyes open, look at one spot on the ceiling. If you have the time, I recommend staying here for about 20 breaths. We'll stay here for two more. Bring your feet back down to the floor. Lift your hips up to take the block out to the side. Bump your hips over to the right. Bring your arms out flat like a capital T. Let your knees fall over to the left. For a gentle twist, you could rest your knees on the block. You could also intensify the twist by extending your left leg towards the front of your mat. One more breath here. Come back to center. Bump your hips over to the left. Let your knees fall to the right. Maybe to the floor. Maybe down to a block. I'll
option to let your head fall over to the left side. One more breath. Come back to center. Final relaxation, Shavasana. I like to put a block under each of my knees for Shavasana. You may like to as well. It gives your low back a little release. Press into the back of your head to tuck your shoulder blades underneath your spine and let your eyes drift closed. Let go of your on-purpose breathing and come back to your normal natural breath. And you may choose to stay here for 5 or 10 minutes, which is super duper good for your nervous system to process all of the gifts that you've been given by showing up on your mat today. Otherwise, as you're ready, or if you're low on time, roll over to your right side into a fetal position. You could rest your head on your arm. Keep your eyes closed for a couple of breaths. And as you're ready, press into your top hand to come up into a comfortable seated position. Bring your hands to prayer in front of your chest. And we'll take one big breath together. Inhale. Open mouth, exhale. Bring your thumbs to touch the middle of your forehead. May all beings everywhere be blessed with happiness and freedom. May the thoughts, words, and actions of our own lives contribute to that happiness and freedom for all. We bow forward, and together we say namaste. Have a great rest of your day.